Hello, good morning students. I am Sudipto, your GK teacher. Today I will discuss from the beginning, and this class is for class 6. Okay, in this class I will discuss from your book Know and Grow with Derek, and I will start from the very first chapter from your book Know and Grow with Derek. If you want to open your book, you may open. If you don't open your book, still there is no problem, because each and every chapter I have written, and I will present those chapter as a slide in front of you. Okay, so just stay tuned with me. Let's begin. It is section A, and there are two segments. First segment is India, our country, and second segment is sports roundup. Okay, each segment contains four different chapters. So first segment, India, our country, it contains first chapter, that is cities, towns and states. Second chapter, tourism India. Third chapter, classical dances of India. And fourth chapter, our constitution. Next segment, sports roundup, it contains fifth chapter, know your sports. Sixth chapter, great sports persons of today. Seventh chapters, championships, trophies and cups. Eighth chapter, artistic gymnastics. Okay, so let's begin from the very first chapter from your book. It is the first chapter from your book India, our country. It is the first chapter. It is cities, towns and states. So here, match these cities and towns with the states in which they are located. There are two columns. One column is cities and towns, and second column is states. So in the left hand side, the cities and towns, there are 10 options. Okay, the first option, cities and towns, Mumbai, Pune, Nagpur. You have to tell the answer in which this Mumbai, Pune or Nagpur, these cities are located. Okay, so I think you know it very well. I'll tell you the answer at the last of this chapter. The second option is Kolkata, Asansol and Darjeeling. You have to tell the state of those cities. Third is Chennai, Salem, Vellore. Okay, you have to tell the state. Second is Bengaluru, Mangaluru and Mysore. Fifth is Kochi, Kohodikod and Alappuzha. Sixth is Ahmedabad, Gandhinagar, Rajkot. Seventh is Jaipur, Udaipur, Ajmer. Eighth is Bhubaneswar, Puri, Katak. Ninth is Gwalior, Indore, Bhopal. Tenth is Jhansi, Lucknow, Agra. Then you have to tell the answer. There are also 10 10 answers are also there. So according to the state and the cities, you have to put the answer, cities and towns number by the side of the states. So here the first is Pune, Mumbai, Nagpur. So here A, Tamil Nadu. So here question number 3, that is Chennai, Salem and Vellore. Chennai, Salem and Vellore, these cities are located in Tamil Nadu. Okay, the next is answer number 5, means Kochi, Kozhikode and Alappuzha. These cities are located in Kerala. Now next, cities and towns number 9, means Gwalior, Indore and Bhopal. These cities or towns are located in Madhya Pradesh. It is the state of Rajasthan, and cities and towns are Jaipur, Udaipur and Ajmer. So Jaipur, Udaipur and Ajmer, this cities or towns are located in Rajasthan. The next, Maharashtra. So Maharashtra, such as Mumbai, Pune and Nagpur, these cities and towns are located in Maharashtra. Next, it is option number 8, such as Bhubaneswar, Puri and Cuttack. These cities and towns are located in Odisha. Then cities and towns number 6, that is Ahmedabad, Gandhinagar and Rajkot. These towns are located in Gujarat. Option number 10, that is Jhansi, Lucknow and Agra. These cities are located in Uttar Pradesh. Option or cities or towns number 2, that is Kolkata, Asansol and Darjeeling. These cities or towns are located in West Bengal. Next, 4, such as Mangaluru and Mysore. These cities or towns are located in Karnataka. Okay, now go to the next chapter, and the name of this chapter is India, Our Country. It is the segment, it is the A segment, and the name of this chapter is Touring India. Sorry, okay, so now it is the second chapter, and the name of the chapter is Touring India. Okay, so the questions are fill in the blanks using the help box. So this is the help box, and with the help of this box you have to fill up this gap. Okay, so first question is built by Maharaja Swasi Pratap Swai Pratap Singh, the dash has 953 pink sandstone windows called Jharokhas. So the answer will be Hawa Mahal. Okay, this is the answer will be Hawa Mahal. You have to write it. The answer is Hawa Mahal. Actually there was a technical error, that's why the answers are not coming. But I am telling you the answer. It is Hawa Mahal. The second question is built by King Narasimha Deva in the 13th century. The dash designed in the form of a chariot and is dedicated to Lord Surya. So it would be Konark Sun Temple. The second answer will be the Konark Sun Temple. Okay, third question. The dash was built by Akbar. It was traditionally known as Badalgarh. So the answer will be Agra Port. fourth question, the dash contain a collection of rock art linked to Lord Shiva. They are located on the island of Gharapuri in Maharashtra. So the answer will be Brihadrishva. Okay, it is the answer Brihadishvara. Brihadishvara, it is the answer of question it is not the answer of question number fourth. The answer of question number fourth is Elephanta Caves. It is the answer of question number fourth, Elephanta Caves. Now question number fifth, the Dash Temple in Tanjavur built by King Rajaraja Chola is one of the finest examples of Chol architecture. So it is a question number five, and the answer will be Brihadishvara. It is the answer Brihadishvara. Okay, now question number sixth. Question number six. The dash is Jaipur in an astronomical observatory built in the early 18th century. And the answer is Jantar Mantar. Okay, here is the answer, that is Jantar Mantar. Now seven, the Panch Dash of Mahabalipuram, named after the Pandavs, were carved out a single huge rock. It is, the answer is Rats, R-A-T-H-A-S, Rats. So there are five Rats, and the Rats names are after five Pandavs. So it is called the Panch Rats. Now question number eight, the dash as built as a memorial to the first Empress of India in Kolkata and was opened to the public in 1921. So it is a very very famous and a heritage building of West Bengal. It is called Victoria Memorial. Okay, it is situated in Kolkata. So second chapter is completed. Now the third chapter. The third chapter is about classical dances of India. India is a land of culture, India is a land of music, a land of festival. So there are so many types of classical dances in India. Here, read the clues and fill the missing letters. So actually, I have just gapped here for writing the answer. In the book you will find the same. So the question is, this dance form begins with Alaripu, means flowering bud. So the answer is Bharatanatyam. Okay, second, in this dance form the characters are defined by their costumes and makeup. The face of the artist is painted over to appear as though a mask is on. So it is Kathakali. The name of this dance form is derived from a word that means story. So it is Kathak. Ra, Sankirtan and Thangta are the most popular variations of this dance form from the northeast, and it is called Manipuri. The Odhra Magadha is the oldest form of this dance from the Odisha, and it is Odishi. The name of this dance form is also the name of a village in the Krishna district of Andhra Pradesh, and the name of the dance style is Kuchipudi. Okay? So here, classical dances of India, chapter number 3 is completed. Now, our constitution means the constitution of India. It is very, very important and honorable thing to us. Okay? So our constitution, you should know about our constitution. The constitution of India lays down the laws and guidelines that establish the structure, procedures, powers and duties of government institutions. It also states the fundamental rights, directive principles and the guide and the duties of citizens. The preamble states that we, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economical and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our constitution, in our constitute assembly, this 26 days of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. Feature: the constitution of India is the longest written constitution of any sovereign country in the world. It begins with the preamble. Dr. B. R. Ambedkar was the chairman of the drafting committee of the constitution. The constitution of India came to force on 26 January 1950. The constitution of India states that any citizen over the age of 18 is eligible to vote in an election. So it was a very short introduction about our Indian constitution. Now, I'll move to chapter number 5th, sports roundup. Identify and write the name of these sports using the help box. Okay, here are some clues within the help box, and you have to write the name of the games according to the clues. In this sport, the participants jump off a 3M springboard or a 10M platform at the Olympic Games. You have to guess what would be the answer. Next, I will tell you the answer. A game in which two or four players use rackets to hit a small hollow rubber ball against the walls of an indoor court. You have to tell the answer. Greco-Roman and freestyle are two popular forms of this sport. Question number 4. It is a sport in which
the participants attempt to lift heavy weights and are mounted on steel bars.
Question number 5.
Floor, balance beams, vault and uneven bars are different equipments used in this sport.
Question number 6.
This is a team sport played outdoor on horseback, where the object is to score goals against an opposing team.
Now question number 7.
Foil, epee and sabre are the 3 power points used in this Olympic sport. The Tour de France is one of the most well-known tournaments of this sport.
So these are the questions. So I'm repeating question number 7.
Foil, epee and sabre are the 3 weapons used in this Olympic sports.
So now I'm going to tell you the answer. The first question was, in this sport the participants jumped off a 3M springboard on a 10M platform at the Olympic Games, and the name of the game is diving.
Second question, a game in which 2 or 4 players use rackets to hit a small hollow rubber ball against the wall of an indoor court, and the name of the game is squash.
Greco-German and freestyle are 2 popular forms of this sports, and it is wrestling.
Question number 4th. It is a sport in which the participants attempt to lift heavy weights and are mounted on steel bars.
It is weightlifting.
Question number 5th. Floor balance beams, vault and unseen bars are different equipment used in this sports, and this is gymnastics.
Question number 6.
This is a team sport played outdoors on horseback, where the object is to score goals against an opposing team. This is polo.
Question number 7.
Foil, epee and sabre are the 3 weapons used in this Olympic sport, that is called fencing.
Question number 8.
The Tour de France is one of the most well-known tournaments of this sport, and it is signaling.
I'm very sorry, it would be cycling, C-Y-C-L-I-N-G, okay? It would be C. Cycling, okay. It would be cycling, C-Y-C-L-I-N-G.
Now, next. Chapter number 6. Great sportsperson of today. Identify this great sportsperson and the sport they play using the help box. There are 6 sportsmen and you have to guess the name and their sports. So the first picture is LeBron James and sports name is basketball. Next, Carolina Marlin, and sports name is badminton. This is Magnus Carlsen. Okay, and the name of his sports is, I'm telling you, it is chess. Okay, it is chess here. It is chess. Magnus Carlsen. Magnus Carlsen, his sports is chess. Next, Rory McIlroy. Rory McIlroy, it is, and his sports name is golf. Lewis Hamilton, sports name is Formula One. Mo Farah, and sports name is athletes. Now it is chapter number 7, championships, trophies and cups. So there are two columns you have to match this championships, trophies and cups with the sport. Okay, so first, this is first column, this is second column. First column is Copa Libertadores, FA Cup, Ballon d'Or. It's the name of the trophy or championship. Second is Frank Aurel Trophy, Wisden Trophy, and Trans Tasman's Trophy. Trans Tasman. Third is Linares Dortmund MTEL Masters. Fourth is Championship Trophy Sultan Azlan Shah Cup, Asia Cup. Fifth is Thomas Cup, Sudirman Cup, All England. Sixth is Davis Cup, Hopman Cup, Venus Rosewater Dish. Seventh is Augustus Master US Open, the Open Championship. Eighth is NBA World Championship, European Championship. So now, and the name of the sports here, the options are chess, badminton, basketball, tennis, football, golf, hockey and cricket. So it is, here is the answer. It is the option number 3, Linares Dortmund MTEL Masters. So it is the championship and the name of the sports is chess. There is the fifth, Thomas Cup, Sudirman Cup, All England. Okay, and the name of the sports is badminton. Now, at 8, NBA World Championship, European Championship. It is, the name of the sports is basketball. Now it is question number, answer number 3, and the option is Davis Cup, Hopman Cup, and Venus Rosewater Dish. And the name of the sports is tennis. It is 1, Copa Libertadores, Libertadores, FA Cup, Ballon d'Or. It is, the name of the sports is football. 7, Augusta Masters, US Open, the Open Championship. And the name of the sports is golf. And it is fourth, the championship and the trophy name is Champions Trophy Sultan Azlan Shah Cup, Asia Cup. It is, the name of the sports is hockey. And second is cricket and the championship is Frank Aurel Trophy, Wisden Trophy, Trans Tasman Trophy. So it is all for now, students. It is the end of this class, of this video class. Next,
I'll come and I'll start from chapter number 8. Okay? So stay at your home. Don't go outside. Focus on your study. Okay? Thank you. Have a good day.